Words like comorbidity, lockdown, flattening the curve are some of the terms that made it to our everyday vocabulary thanks to COVID-19 pandemic. Now, the Kerala government has introduced a new terminology, superspread, to tag the outbreak of the disease in the coastal wards of Thiruvananthapuram Corporation. There is a superspreader in Puthenpally ward, a fish merchant who could have transmitted the disease to 21 people, including his close family members. But the tally in Poonthura is proving too big to be traced to a single person. In the last 3 days alone, over 150 were declared positive in 4 coastal wards alone. So who is a super spreader? A super spreader individual has a higher than average tendency to infect a more significant number of people, making contact tracing difficult or impossible. A person's behavior, travel patterns, and degree of contact with others can also contribute to super spreading. Some people shed far more virus and for more extended period than others, perhaps because of differences in their immune system. You have seen the visuals of droplets go flying when someone coughs or sneezes. But even when you talk, you emit more particles than when you breathe, and emission increases as you speak louder. Now let us try to understand this phenomena through a case that occurred in early March. Around 61 members of a choir group met for their weekly practice in Washington. One of them had cold-like symptoms, which turned out to be COVID-19 later. Inadvertently, the person ended up infecting 52 others with COVID-19. 2 members of the group later died. Now, I'm not trying to scare you here, but this is the reality. A super-spreading event occurs where people gather and end up getting infected unknowingly. You also need to know that these choir members did not have any physical contact. Experts assume that the virus could have spread through exhaled droplets. In Texas, a person unknowingly infected 18 people in a birthday party involving 25 people. The more individuals you pile into one place, the higher the opportunity for the coronavirus to infect many people at once. Super-spreading events have taken place in a dormitory for migrant workers in Singapore, live music venues in Japan's Osaka, and Zumba classes in South Korea. This explains why the authorities are worried about your marriage plans, the night party in Idukki, and the fish markets. Now, how can we control this? It is better to avoid indoor gatherings, high touch points like no door knobs, use of public restrooms, and more. It is your behavioral pattern that matters for you and others. Right control practices like hand washing, masks, quarantine, reducing social contacts can slow the transmission rate and halt a super spreading event. Now, coming back to the case in densely packed coastal hamlets like Poonthura, not only are houses jammed close together, but 8 to 10 people are stuffed in small boxy homes, not wide enough for even 3 people. In such poor pockets, there is just a single toilet for 5 to 6 houses. Social distancing is laughable for people leading such a crowded lifestyle. With a triple lockdown, the authorities are trying to prevent them from transmitting outside the community. But now, let's hope that things will get back to normal soon.